They only rolled out Gemini 1, what was it, last week? And Gemini itself is barely 2 months old, but Google today launched Gemini 1.5 to developers and enterprise users, offering support for 1 million tokens, and says Gemini 1.5 Pro is on par with its Gemini Ultra model, quoting The Verge. There are a lot of improvements in Gemini 1.5. Gemini 1.5 Pro, the general purpose model in Google's system, is apparently on par with the high-end Gemini Ultra that the company only recently launched, and it bested Gemini 1.0 Pro on 87% of benchmark tests. It was made using an increasingly common technique known as mixture of experts, or MOE, which means it only runs part of the overall model when you send in a query rather than processing the whole thing the whole time. That approach should make the model both faster for you to use and more efficient for Google to run. But there's one new thing in Gemini 1.5 that has the whole company, starting with CEO Sundar Pichai, especially excited. Gemini 1.5 has an enormous context window, which means it can handle much larger queries and look at much more information at once. That window is a whopping 1 million tokens, compared to 128,000 for OpenAI's GPT-4 and 32,000 for the current Gemini Pro. Tokens are a tricky metric to understand, so Pichai makes it simpler. It's about 10 or 11 hours of video, tens of thousands of lines of code. The context window means you can ask the AI bot about all of that content at once. Pichai also says Google's researchers are testing a 10 million token context window. That's like the whole series of Game of Thrones all at once. As he's explaining this to me, Pichai notes offhandedly that you can fit the entire Lord of the Rings trilogy into that context window. This seems too specific, so I ask him, this has already happened, hasn't it? Someone in Google is just checking to see if Gemini spots any continuity errors, trying to understand the complicated lineage of Middle-earth and seeing if maybe AI can finally make sense of Tom Bombadil. I'm sure it has happened, Pichai says with a laugh, or will happen, one of the two. Pichai also thinks the larger context window will be hugely useful for businesses. This allows use cases where you can add a lot of personal context and information at the moment of the query, he says. Think of it as we have dramatically expanded the query window. He imagines filmmakers might upload their entire movie and ask Gemini what reviewers might say. He sees companies using Gemini to look over masses of financial records. I view it as one of the bigger breakthroughs we have done, he says, end quote. Quoting TechCrunch, Gemini 1.5 Pro can take in 700,000 words or 30,000 lines of code, 35x the amount Gemini 1.0 Pro can handle, and the model being multimodal, it's not limited to text. Gemini 1.5 Pro can ingest up to 11 hours of audio or an hour of video in a variety of different languages. To be clear, that's an upper bound. The version of Gemini 1.5 Pro available to most developers and customers starting today in a limited preview can only process around 100,000 words at once. Google's characterizing the large data input Gemini 1.5 Pro as experimental, allowing only developers approved as part of a private preview to pilot it via the company's Gen AI Dev Tool AI Studio. Several customers using Google's Vertex AI platform also have access to the large data input Gemini 1.5 Pro, but not all. During the private preview, Gemini 1.5 Pro with the 1 million token context window will be free to use, Google says, but the company plans to introduce pricing tiers in the near future that start at the standard 128,000 context window and scale up to 1 million tokens. I have to imagine the larger context window won't come cheap, and Google didn't allay fears by opting not to reveal pricing during the briefing. If pricing's in line with Anthropic's, it could cost $8 per million prompt tokens and $24 per million generated tokens. But perhaps it'll be lower. Stranger things have happened. We'll have to wait and see, end quote. Google also made Gemini 1.0 Pro and Gemini 1.0 Ultra generally available today, adding support for adapter-based tuning in Vertex and rolling out new developer tools.